Hey y'all, today I'm gonna show you how to do some prep with the rutabaga. This is a rutabaga, I want you to be able to see it. Not a lot of people have necessarily worked with rutabaga, so this is what it looks like. I'm gonna show you an example of what it's not, which is a turnip, right? You know, if this was smaller, I could see how you might see, you know, there's a lot of similarities. There's this kind of purplish color that they both have towards this top part, and then this sort of whiter or creamier, but you'll notice this is more of like a pale cream color and this is a little bit yellower. So that's one of the main ways to tell the difference. And you know, the shape is a little bit different and this is clearly a lot larger. Turnips can get bigger and you can definitely find these as smaller, and it's often easy to confuse the two. But they are in fact two different vegetables. This one is bred from this one though, so they do have some relationship, which is why if you have a hard time getting your hands on a rutabaga, you can substitute some turnips. Just make sure you see again the size difference, right? So you know, you might need two turnips for one rutabaga depending on what size I tell you to get. So that's that about the two of them. So with the rutabaga, like with any of our kind of root vegetables like this, basically the biggest thing you need to do is just take off the tough outer skin. You see it's got that layer of skin on there. So to do that, I'm gonna cut it into smaller pieces to just make it easier on myself to deal with. So I've done that, and then I can take my knife and go around the side and take off that rough outer edge. And again, you see this kind of creamy yellow color that the flesh has. It's really pretty. It has a nice mild flavor to it, and it's a really great substitute for things like potato and other like vegetables like that, because even though it's a tuberous kind of root veggie, really, I guess it's not really a tuber, it's just a root vegetable, it doesn't have the same amount of starchiness as you'll find with potatoes. So it could be a good substitute for that. And of course, it's got a different nutritional profile, which we like the variety. So you see, I've worked around the whole way, I've gotten the all the skin off. From here, I can do any number of things. I could cut this piece in half and then grate it on the grater. I'm not gonna show you how to do that because we've covered grating before. Grating's hopefully relatively self-explanatory, but I can do that. I could cut sort of slices off of it like this, and then maybe cut it down that way and almost create like little rutabaga fries in some respect. And then I can also just do larger sort of chunks and pieces. With the rutabaga, one of the things to think about is if you are cutting it into pieces, you wanna try and keep the pieces at a relatively even size. That just helps it cook better. So you can do large pieces, like maybe I would end there and say I was done, or I could take it and do some smaller pieces like that. You can go smaller still, you can go bigger still. That's the basics though of how to kind of start the process of prepping the rutabaga, and then you can do any kind of number of preps with it from there. All right, that's it with the rutabaga. I'm gonna finish this up.